Welcome student. Today we have to see second part of the same unit, and that second part is phase rule. In order to study phase rule, we must know some terms before study this phase rule. Now, if we consider any system, now in any system, each phase is physically distinct and mechanically separable. Such a part in any system which is physically distinct and mechanically separable, such a part is known as phase. Are you getting clear? What is mean by phase? Now, if we consider any system, then in any system, physically distinct and mechanically separable part, that mechanically separable part itself is a homogeneous, such a part is called as phase. Means phase can be defined as it is mechanically separable and physically distinct homogeneous part of system is phase. Now, in any system consisting of more than one phases, then such a system is heterogeneous system. If in any system, if there are more than one phases, then such a system is known as heterogeneous system. If we consider water system, if we take example of water system, all of us know that water exists in three phases. How many phases? Three phases. You know ice, that is water in solid phase. Then drinking water, that is water in liquid phase, and water vapor. Okay, here there is water system, but in this water system there are three parts: water as solid, water as liquid, and water as vapor. These three parts are mechanically separable, physically distinct. That's why this water system is three phase system. ओके, समझ में आया? सबसे पहले फेज रूल में अपन ने देखा व्हाट इज मीन बाय फेज. आर यू गेटिंग क्लियर? व्हाट इज फेज? फेज कैन बी डिफाइंड एज मैकेनिकली सेपरेबल एंड फिजिकली डिस्टिंक्ट होमोजीनियस पार्ट ऑफ सिस्टम इज अ फेज. ओके, if in any system if there are more than one phases, then such a system is heterogeneous system. Now if we take the if we study the effect of pressure, then another term, that is one can say temperature or concentration. Means if we study the effect of pressure, temperature and concentration on system, then it is studied, this study is related to phase rule. And this phase rule is known as Gibbs phase rule. But in order to study this Gibbs phase rule in detail, first of all, you must know some basic thing. First thing we already studied, that is phase. Second, component. And third, degree of freedom. If you know these three terms, then it is easy to study the phase rule or Gibbs phase rule. First phase, we studied it. Phase can be defined as, it is the homogeneous entity which is mechanically separable and physically distinct. It is known as phase. Now, if we consider example, then you know water is three phase system, because three phases are in equilibrium in water system. Water solid, that is ice, okay, it is liquid and it is vapor, okay, that's why water is three phase system, okay. Now see second example. You know in our environment there is a mixture of gases, okay, that's why all the gases mix in all proportion in environment, okay, and it forms one phase system, means mixture of gases it is one phase system. Now see next example, that is third example. If two liquids are miscible into each other, if we take example of water and ethanol, if in a beaker, let me assume water is taken as 5 ml, then ethyl alcohol, that is C2H5OH, is also taken in 1 or 2 ml, then stir it. What happens? It can form homogeneous mixture. Okay? Here, this system, ethanol plus water, this system is one phase system, though both are liquids, but when they mix, they forms a homogeneous mixture. That's why water and ethanol, or acetone and water, these are nothing but one phase system. If we consider example of, one can say, benzene and water. Now in this case also both are liquid, but these two liquids are immiscible, they are not mixed into each other, they can form layer just like oil and water, okay. Oil and water cannot mix, there is a layer formation between these two liquid. In the same manner, benzene and water can also form a layer between them, means these two liquids are immiscible, that's why it is two phase system. Matlab yahan par apna ek concept clear ho gaya. Phase definition samajh mein aayi. Examples, homogeneous mixture hai to just like ethanol and water, one phase, ओके, मिक्सचर ऑफ गैसेस, होमोजेनियस मिक्सचर ऑफ गैसेस वन फेज, टू इमिसिबल लिक्विड टू फेजेस, दो दे बोथ आर लिक्विड्स. ओके, एग्जाम्पल्स बेंजीन वाटर और ऑयल एंड वाटर. नाउ वाटर इज थ्री फेज सिस्टम बिकॉज यू नो देयर इज इक्विलिब्रियम बिटवीन थ्री फेजेस, सॉलिड दैट इज आइस, वाटर ड्रिंकिंग वाटर एज लिक्विड एंड वेपर्स. दैट्स व्हाई वाटर इज थ्री फेज सिस्टम. नाउ सी सेकंड पॉइंट दैट इज कंपोनेंट. नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू मस्ट नो कंपोनेंट. व्हाट इज मीन बाय कंपोनेंट? नाउ कंपोनेंट कैन बी डिफाइन एज smallest number of independent variable in terms of which composition of each phase can be expressed at equilibrium is known as component. See once again, component, definition of component, smallest number of independent variables in terms of which composition of each phase can be expressed at equilibrium is known as component. Now see examples of component. First example, if we consider water system, you know in water system how many phases are there? We studied it. You know it is three phase system. Okay, but you are going to study about the component. Now three phases are, which are the three phases? H2O in solid phase is in equilibrium with H2O in liquid phase and equilibrium in H2O in vapor phase. Three phases are there. Actually, initially written in this way. Okay? But chemical composition of ice is H2O. Chemical composition of liquid, water, liquid state is also H2O. In vapor state, it is also H2O. Means here, though it is a three phase, but each phase can be expressed chemically as H2O, H2O, H2O. Okay, that's why this is one component system. मतलब यहां पर एक concept अपना exactly clear हो गया. Water is a three phase one component system. Why? Because in water three phases are there, solid, liquid, vapor. That's why it is three phase. And since composition of each phase can be expressed as H2O, that's why it number of components are one. Now if you take the example of salt and water, mixture of salt and water, second example, salt, any salt like potassium iodide and water, here this system is two component system. How many components are there? Two. Why? Because here salt Ki is dissolved in water. Chemical composition of potassium iodide is Ki and water as H2O. Different. That's why it is two component system. But how many phases are there? See, in this If we consider salt and water, there are four phases. Ki solid, then H2O solid, H2O means solution, liquid, and then vapor. That's why it is a four phase system. Okay, now all this can be expressed in terms of two individuals. This system can be expressed in terms of two individuals, Ki and H2O. That's why it is a two component system. If you take a third example, that is CaCO3, decomposition of CaCO3, then CaCO3 in solid phase dissociates to gives CaCO3 dissociate solid, it gives CaO solid plus CO2 gas. Here it is a three phase system. Three phases are there. Why three phases? CaCO3 solid, CaO solid, and CO2 gas. Three phase. Now, how many number of components are there? Two. This is important. Why? Because composition of each phase can be expressed in terms of another two. Here, chemical composition of CaCO3 is equals to CaO plus CO2. That's why CaCO3 can be expressed in terms of these two. That's why this system, though there are three phases, but it is a two component system. CaO can also be expressed as CaCO3 minus CO2. Okay, means CaO can be expressed in terms of these two, or this can be expressed in terms of these two. That's why it is a two component system. Okay, now in the next period, we are going to see about third point, that is degree of freedom, and later on we are going to discuss about the Gibbs phase rule. Thank you.